Hey, what up, gamers? I'm back again with another pickups video. And as you can see, I got a lot of good stuff here. This is a good pickup video for me. This is a milestone video because I would have completed two series for my Neo Geo MVS. So I'm excited about that. So stick around to the end so I can show y'all what that's all about, because I'm pretty excited about that. So let's get on with the pickup, because I got a variety of stuff here, which has actually been a pretty good pickups time for me here. So let's start out with this tabletop, which is a Tron tabletop. Some of this stuff I'm going to have to get in close too, so forgive me if I'm out of the screenshot, but this is Tron tabletop to add to my tabletop collection. I was kind of excited to get that. Actually, here to go with that, I got this Tron. It's a beta. Let me show you this. It's a beta MVS. I mean, not MVS. I'm sorry. Beta video tape. And they were selling at the pawn shop too, you know. I mean, not the pawn shop, but the game shop. And I was like, you know what? They only wanted a few dollars for it. I said, it would be nice to go along with my Tron collection here. So that's both of those that I thought that was actually kind of cool. But now, I'm going to get in here tight again to show you this, because this, I really dig. This is Capcom Udon's Art of Capcom, and it's a complete collection. And man, is this thing here. I'm gonna get this way so I can really get in here for y'all, so y'all can see some of these pictures, man, because some of these pictures are like just insane. I mean, I'm like, oh my goodness, that's the one. You know, I gotta leave it on the one with the Kuma, because that is an awesome shot. It's that guy out in there too. But now here, I'm gonna show you, because they got different sections too. So there's a boxer, a ball rod, and then here, I'm going to show you, like, say, like, this is, you know, the Darkstalkers series, you know. So just some really good artwork, man. Just some really, really good artwork, man. I really dig this book. But like I said, it's the art of Udon. I guess it's from the comic books from Capcom. So this is what I like. Here, I'm also show you this while I'm out up in front of the camera here, because this is another book I got. Now, I got that other one from the Half Price Book. So this one I got from Half Price Books too. This is Castlevania, man, which I thought is a collector's deal here. Castlevania, Lord of Shadows. You know, it's a collector's book. Here's what it looked like. This is sealed too. But I don't know. I might open it. I might not. I don't know. But I figured, you know, I'll let y'all check it out. Here, let me see if I can get it in tight. You know, but pretty nice, man. Just some nice books. I thought was good to kind of collect here. I'm going to show you some figures I got here. Some action figures. Now, these, my friend of mine, Eric, I got to give a shout out to him. He really hooked me up with a lot of good stuff I'm going to be showing y'all on this show here. But here's some Street Fighter Muscles figures. So this one here got like Bison, Ryu, and Vega in it. Let's see if you can see that right there. Yeah, and then this one got, I can't even tell. Let me see. I think that's E. Honda, Chun-Li, and Zangief. And Zangief in this. So these were kind of cool to pick up too. And I thought these were kind of nice. And then another thing I got here, that, like I said, these are kind of small. That's the reason why I'm kind of getting in tight on these. But I saw these figures. These were at Walmart, as a matter of fact. And these are, I just bought the Shadow Blue figures. I just figured, you know what? I'm going to buy the Shadow Blue figures. I like these. So this here is a ball rod. This here is a Vega. This here is a Sagat. And this one here is M. Bison. So, and then here I'm going to show you my other figure here. Now, this is the only pop I got. I'm not a big pop fan, but my son came over with this Akuma pop. couldn't pass that up. So, you know, I said, that's my Kuma Pop. So, like I said, I wanted to get in tight to kind of show y'all those. You know, I thought those were pretty cool. They were pretty cool pieces to have there. So, here, let me just put some of this back. But anyway, let's look at, okay, this thing here. Now, this is just one of those, what do you call these things? You know, the plug and plays. And the reason why I wanted this plug and play is because it has the kill screen on Pac-Man. You know, I think it's level 256 or 253 or something like that. So I really wanted this. I thought this was a good piece to pick up. You know, I didn't pay that much for it, but I really wanted to have that. So, but anyway, let's take a look at this. Now this I just picked up. I just found this at the pawn shop just the other day. This is actually Pitfall, and my boy Eric. Like I said, I'm gonna be mentioning his name a lot here because he's at a game shop in a toy shop in Duluth. You know, but that's my buddy. You know, and he hooked me up with this, which is a Atari standard joystick boxed. So that, you know, I thought that was a nice one to add to the collection there. Let's look at some of these Genesis games here. So I got picked these Genesis games up. This is basically Sonic 1, Sonic 2, and Sonic 3. You know, these were and Mortal Kombat. You know, all of these are complete. I got a good deal on those, so I thought that was pretty good to have. Here, let's look at some of these PlayStation games. Some of these PlayStation games I ended up picking up here. But now, this is a good one, because this one you don't hardly find. I picked this one up at Half Price Books. This is Battle Assault 3, the Gundam series. So this was, I actually got 1 and 2 for the PlayStation, so I thought this one was a good one to pick up. So I got that one too. And then here we got Ultimate Alliance for the Xbox. God of War. This God of War 1 and 2, I think this is God of War. God of War. And I got Legends of Wrestling. All these are complete, I'm pretty sure. Cue ball. Lara Croft Tomb Raider Anniversary. Indiana Jones. This is Indiana Jones and the Emperor's Tomb. I need to play this. I never played any of these Indiana Jones. I think I'm kind of interested in checking those out. But anyway, let's see what we got here. I got one PS4 game. This is when we got into the adventure theme. I picked this up, the Uncharted series for the PS4, which is Uncharted 1, 2, and 3, which I thought was a good one. I got a good deal on that. And some PS3 games, you're kind of finding a lot of these out here pretty cheaply now. And what I picked up the Batman series. So I got, for the PS3, I got Arkham Knight, which, you know, is the Game of the Year edition. They got everything unlocked, which I thought was nice to have. The Game of the Year edition of Arkham City, you know, got that one too. And also Batman Origins. Batman Origins, so I got that one too. All right. And then we got Lost Planets 2. And then some of the games that I think I really wanted to pick up and try out, which is actually Borderlands 1 and Borderlands 2. I always heard these are some pretty good games, so I figured I would get these just to see how they are. So I'm kind of excited to play those and just to see how they are. Saints Row, now this is Saints Row 4, so I was able to find Saints Row 4. That's another series that I said I wanted to check out too. I actually picked 1, 2, and 3 up for the 360, which you're going to see in a moment, so I thought that was actually pretty nice. And I found a sealed copy here of Def Jam rap star. You know, like I said, you know, it's a sealed copy, so it might well have some sealed there. There's a Xbox 360 controller I found that saved us for like $6. I think those come in handy. And moving on into the Xbox 360 games, I think I got some Wii games in here too. Let me just put these on back. So I got Dead or Alive Extreme 2. Dead or Alive Extreme 2 for the Xbox 360. This is Lost Planet Extreme Edition. Got that there. Then we got Blaze Blue. Now this Blaze Blue is Contendium Ship Extended. So got that one for the Xbox here. And then here's my Saints Row series. All these are complete too, by the way. So this Saints Row 1. That's a Platinum Hits one. I think this one's Platinum Hits 2, but I'm like, I just want to try the game, see how I like them. It's Platinum, St. Rose 2, and St. Rose 3. Then also, I was able to pick up a good deal on some Wii games, so I ended up picking up this Super Smash Bros. Brawl for the Wii. And also, Donkey Kong Country Returns. So I got Donkey Kong Country Returns for the week. All right. So, and keeping moving on here, I ended up getting another good deal from my buddy at Eric again. He actually hooked me up with a Super Famicom. So here's the Famicom. He hooked me up with the Famicom. I got a pro price for that. So Eric, I appreciate that. That's a pro price for that. Along with some games here. Now some of these games I don't really know what they are. But this one we got a Transformers box. I know what that one is. This one looked like a Gundam game if I had to guess. I don't know if you can see that all right. But that's a Gundam game. This one I was kind of familiar with. That's King Kong 2. This one, I have no idea. This one, no idea. This one I got Bomberman. This is Bomberman, which is a good game. I played that one. I like that. This Macross game, I tried that. I like that. And the reason why I really wanted this deal is because I got Gradius 2. I couldn't pass that Gradius 2 up for the Famicom. I had to go for that. Alright. So then I ended up I ended up picking up some Super Nintendo games. So I ended up getting UN Squadron and Thunder Spirits. So both of those were the Super Nintendo. Then I also have some Nintendo games I picked up here too, which is Quantum Fighter. I'm getting Quantum Fighter there. Kirby's Adventure, and a Contra. Got that Contra too from a guy here. So I got a lot of good deals from my buddy. So I appreciate that too. So got those. And here, let's look into some of these. I got some import Dreamcast game here. I got this import Dreamcast game, which is Psychic Force 2012. Then I ended up picking up this Virtual Pool 3. I like these pool games. Pool games, if anybody got a series of games or games that they just like playing that might not be mainstream or whatever, it's the pool games for me. And it ended up being these virtual pool games. I really played the one for the Xbox. I played that one a lot. You know, that's my game. I just go in, that's like my cigarette. You know, I go in and play that game all of the time. But anyway, I like these virtual pool games. Now this game I saw here, I just bought it. It's a Disney game. It's called for the PS1, Disney's Treasure Planet. I don't know how good that is, but I figured Disney does some good adventure platforming games. So I figured I'd try for the PlayStation. You can really find a lot of PlayStation 1 games out in the wild either. So that's the reason why I bought that. So now also I got some import Saturn games, and I think these are some fighting games here too. So, I got King of Fighters 95 for the Saturn, and King of Fighters 97 for the Saturday. These are imports again, as I said. So now let's take a look at some of these packages I have here. So looking at some of these, look like they put it in the garbage bag. Now this one came from Japan too. Let's take a look at what we got here now. I'm not sure what everything I got. I got an idea, but I'm just not sure of everything that I got here. So we'll kind of take a look at all of this together. This one, I think I know what this is. This is actually, should be a couple, it is. Oh yeah, this is good too. Let's put that down there. So these are a couple more fighters for the import Saturn. I guess, you know, I'm trying to beef up my Saturn collection. Some of these games I had, I thought, and you know, I just got a good deal on them, so I had to buy them in the set. But this is Street Fighter Zero. So, you know, of course, that's a classic one there. Had to end up getting, I thought I had this. I was surprised. I think I got it like in the collection on my PlayStation collection or the Alpha Series collection or something like that. But I didn't have it for the Saturn. It wasn't really that expensive. So I said, I'll throw it in my collection while it's getting scooted. And then this one, I know I had two, but it wasn't complete, which I was surprised. I think it was missing the back. But this is Street Fighter Alpha 2, which happens to be my favorite Street Fighter. This one right here is just killing for me. This is my go-to Street Fighter. If I'm playing a Street Fighter, this Alpha 2 is my go-to Street Fighter. So I really enjoy that. All right, so moving on, I got a couple more, some more packages here. So let's take a look at these. This one, okay. I know what this one is. Now, this one ends up being just a repro. This is a repro. I know it's a repro. I bought it as a repro because I figured I wasn't going to ever have an opportunity to actually buy it new and play it or used and play it. So I figured I'd just buy the repro so I could check it out. Now, they did two of these, too. They did a one and a two, and I heard two was better. So I figured since two is better, I'll try two out, see how I like it, and then if I like it all right, which I'm sure I will because it's another smug, and you know me and my smugs. So this one is, oh my goodness, it's all in Japanese, and I forgot the name of this, y'all. But I'm sure anybody that know this smug is familiar with that. So, but anyway, I'm glad I got it. And since I'm looking at this, you know, I like that they do these repros and they make them kind of complete. For the Mega Drive, man, it's gonna kill me that I can't think of the name of it, but there it is. You know, they do the manual in these too, you know, and stuff. So I'm like, I like with that. So I'm kind of looking forward to this because I love my smugs. And so that one I got. And again, I apologize. I can't remember the name of that. Somebody can put that in the comments for me if you know what that is. But anyway, now this one is another. I don't want to say, I guess you can consider this to be a holy grail, so I'm really kind of excited about this one too, because this one been on my want list for years, and I finally was able to just break down and buy it, and it's a smup too, so you know me, it's smups and smups or shooters and fighters for me, and this one here, like I said, this is definitely, I hate to keep using Holy Grail all the time, but I'm starting to get some of my Holy Grail. What can I tell you? So, you know, and this one is definitely one of the Holy Grails of my shooter. And this, my friends, let's get in tight. The bottle. So, you know, I've been wanting this bad boy for, man, I can't tell you. Let me get back to it. There's the back too. So the back, this was, like I said, this was definitely in my want list. Man, it looks beautiful. It It looks beautiful. It looks like all of the cards are there and everything. Look at this thing, man. So you know I'm going to enjoy this one. So that's it. A borrower for the PS2 is Japanese import. Of course, I got a Japanese PS2. I'm able to play these, so I'm really excited. Really excited to get that a borrower. Then I got some PlayAsia stuff too here too. PlayAsia has some pretty good deals going on. I figured I'd take advantage of their deals. And again, these are smups too. I'm pretty sure they are. And this particular one here, which I'm surprised I didn't get earlier, but you know me, I'm good at waiting. Because, you know, patient man, you get the best deals. And by me waiting, I was able to pick up Caladrius Blade. So Caladrius Blade for the PS4, I was able to get that. Now let's take a look about it too. You know, so I'm excited about this. Cause I always saw a lot of gameplay on this, and I really like this. So I'm really excited about this. I see the game is filed on a coupon offer. I wish I could have used it on my next thing that I got. But anyway, yeah, let's set that up there. Let's put this better bar up there too. But anyway, I like this Sabaro. Yeah, I'm going to put this Sabaro. I'm going to put that Sabaro right there. Also, that Caladrius Blade I put right there too. But anyway, let's look at this one too. Now this one, which those of you who collect smups probably know about this one already. This one was a limited run, and I think it was exclusive to PlayAsia too. So real excited about getting this one too. This is a good one to have in the collection too. I'm not saying it's a holy grail or anything, but it's definitely a good piece to have. Oh, I see they sent me another $5 deal. But anyway, this is, and what is this? Oh, this is a sticker set. Nice. So this is the, let's just drop some here. What is this? This looks like another sticker or something, I guess. But anyway, this is Ghostblade HD Limited Edition. So Ghostblade HD, you need to type this, y'all can see that. Ghostblade HD Limited Edition. And like I said, they gave me some type of stickers in here. So this is some stickers set there. And then another, like a HD sticker set there. But real excited about that. So, you know, here's some nice smups I ended up getting good deals on. Couldn't pass these up. So I'm actually glad that I was able to get these. So now, let's talk about my Neo Geo MVS pickups I got. So again, like I said, I was able to complete two of my MVS series that I was wanting to complete for years. For years, I finally was able to complete them with these two MVS pickups. But I actually got three of them here. So I'm gonna talk about this one first here. So now this first one I got here is Spam Masters. So, end up getting Spam Masters. Yeah, a little tighter here, so y'all can see that. So, end up getting, got a good deal on Spam Masters. I actually like this game. It's pretty fun. So, I ended up looking at Neo Turbo Maniac's review on this, you know, and he told me that I like this game, so, you know, and I trust him, and, you know, he's a good guy. So he was right. It's a good game. I like it. I already beat it. So I really do like it. So now, one of the series that I ended up completing for my MVS collection that I'm really excited about, I ended up getting King of Fighters 2002. So King of Fighters 2002 completes my series for the MVS, for the Street King of Fighters. So I got all of the Street King of Fighters. I think it's 10 of them, so 94 to 2003. I got all of them on MVS, and then I got all of them after that too. Even on the Thomas Wave, I got the Neo Wave, I think, and King of Fighters 11? I know I got it, but anyway, that's King of Fighters. Really excited to complete my King of Fighters series for the MVS. You never know if or when you're ever going to complete an MVS series, a Neo Geo series at all. So this is definitely a milestone for me. I'm really excited about that. And lastly, which is what I'm going to close on this one, because this one is another one that will complete my series of games for the Neo Geo MVS that, of course, just like any Neo Geo freak or like me, you want to be able to complete certain series, and this is definitely one of the ones that I wanted to complete. And I know everybody see that Metal Slug 5. So I was able to get Metal Slug 5 to complete my MVS series for the Metal Slug series, Metal Slug 5. Beat this a few times already. But I'm real excited that I got this. And I'm kind of holding this out while I take this on out of here. But thanks for watching, everybody. I really appreciate it. I hope this video didn't go too long. But I really wanted to get this out there. And again, thanks for watching. I'm real excited that I'm able to complete my MVS series. I already verified. I always verify all of my MVSs that they are actually valid cards. I open them up and go to MVS scan, so I know it's legit, like all of my cards. So again, happy to complete this series. Thanks for all my new subscribers. Thanks for everybody for watching. As always, I appreciate your patronage. And peace.